Today, I'm going to walk through how you can build a landing page using a simple website builder called Card. Now, if you want to check out the full review on Card, then there's a link in the description so you can go do that. But today's focus is going to be on building a landing page. So I'm going to go through what a landing page is, how you can build one in Card, and also stick around until the end because I'm going to have some tips to help you create high converting landing pages. Now, before I craft a landing page using Card, let's just define what a landing page is. And if you really want to have a good look at one on our website, then go to the description or go to nocode.mba/guide to take a look at our landing page that we built. But to define a landing page, it's where users take action on a standalone page. So users take action, and usually, and that's what our focus is going to be on, is where we are trying to get leads. So we're using it to get leads, usually in the way of emails, but also phone numbers too. So a couple of ways you can use it is an email as a service, where you might have these emails that you send out on a weekly basis or daily basis that offer value and emails that people want to sign up to. So this is known as email as a service. But we can also offer a lead magnet, which is this guide or free PDF or video access, which attracts people like a magnet to give their email address in exchange for this. So this is really giving users a reason to do this because they want this free guide. They want the free email course maybe. And then they're giving their details in order to get this in exchange. So before I give the tips on how to create a landing page that converts, let's go inside Card, the website builder, to craft a landing page. And I'm going to show you a couple of my favorite templates too. Hello, and welcome to inside the backend of Card. And I'll leave a link to this website builder so you can sign up. And there are various templates here, so we're going straight into the templates. There's a landing page template, and then there's a form template too. Now, if you want to capture leads, then I recommend the form templates. If you're looking to show something like something coming soon, or you have something for sale and you want to go into depth in what you offer, then it's a little counterintuitive, but go for the landing page one. So we're going to focus on the form, and I've got a couple of templates that I like. First one, there's this one here, newsletter, and then also I chose this one, which we're going to modify slightly too. So this is an example of the newsletter one, where you can see it's pretty obvious what the action you want someone to take. And one tip that I'm going to give you now is to take away any distractions from your landing page. You want to focus on telling the user exactly what they should do and make it obvious what they should do. Now, in this case, they might go down here and click the social icons. So you might want to remove things like that. But you can see there's no menu bar. There's no sidebar. There's nothing else really to click. Instead, you're either going to join the newsletter or not. So you're telling them this is exactly what you want to do. Now, in terms of this inside Card, we're going to see in a minute, you can just change the picture up here. You can change the background, the headline, which is important, the text, obviously, and then link it to the email service provider that you have. Now, the one that we're going to mess around with is this one, which I think is the best template when it comes to a lead magnet. So let's say that you have a free guide on whatever it is that you do, then you can explain here why they need to get this guide today. Sign up to this now. And we're not going to focus so much on the copy here. We'll come to that later. But first, just know you can click any of these features here and change it. So it gets our free guide, for example. Put in the subheader here, change the text here. And then if you want to add different elements, you can click the add button and say image, and then upload your image here. And then you can play around with those things. So you can see, and I don't need to go into too much depth here, it's fairly simple to change elements on the page and to change colors too. In fact, let's do that now. if we click the button over here, you can see it's already on the appearance tab. We can click the color, and I'm just going to say NCMBA red. And I use text expander to remember things like color hexes for me. And you can press done. So we can see this is the color, branding color, that's used for no-code MBA. You might want to move the image up here, for example, and have more text here. But you can see this is the element of the landing page. And like I say, you can change anything you want, like the background color. You might want to make it this beautiful green, yellow color. Include patterns on here. So you might want bokeh for a little bit more of a dramatic effect, for example. But this is just obviously going to be about your styling guide, and it's not looking very stylish right now. But it's just showing you exactly how we can change things around. Now, if we scroll down here, this is the thank you part of the submitting form part. So once someone submits their form, then it goes to this thank you message. Now, speaking of the form, if you click on the form, then you can go to the form type. So it's either a sign up, a contact, or custom. So let's just say sign up. Then this is where you can use all these different email service providers in order to link this form, this landing page, to your email service provider. Now, the two that I have most experience with are ActiveCampaign and ConvertKit. Sorry, ActiveCampaign and MailChimp. So let's just use ActiveCampaign. This is when you add in your URL, API URL, API key, and the action you want to take. So it's either going to create a contact, add to contact list, or add contact to automation. So for example, let's say that you have a free guide, and then when they download the free guide, you send them a thank you email. That's the automation that you can use. So this is just a matter of reading the guide here, and it's going to tell you exactly where to get this from once you click that link there. So those are the basics of creating a landing page using Card. And you can see just how simple it is to get these templates and then craft them in a way that is going to fit for what you offer. Let's focus on some landing page tips now, which are really important when it comes to conversions, because if you're going to craft a landing page, you want people to convert. You want to increase your conversion rate. And one of the best tips from my experience is to focus on benefits and not features. So you might say, get a free PDF, for example, where this is a feature. You know, you're going to get a PDF and it's free. But you're not really explaining why. You're not really talking about the benefits. Instead, you can say, learn the secrets of AI wizards, for example, where this invokes more of an emotion to go and take action. And if you ever want to link features and benefits together, a great phrase is so that. Download this free PDF today so that you can learn the secrets of AI wizards and tell your user what action they need to take. So tell them, enter your email address, enter your name, and click that button. Make it clear on that landing page what action they need to take. So hopefully you found that helpful. If you have, then please do us a favor and just click that like button, share this video with a friend, and then also if you're new here, subscribe to the channel. And also just take a look in the description to look at the free guide that we have and check out our landing page, to look at the courses we have, and also just to see what other videos we have for you too. Okay, thanks for watching. I'll speak to you soon. Bye-bye.